Hey, I'm Philly. It's Friday, April 19th, and this is your Friday Fix. Ain't no more winter is coming, okay? Winter is here. For all of my Game of Thrones fans, we can be relieved that winter is finally here and that long night is coming. Winter is legendary on Game of Thrones because it could supposedly last generations. There's whole characters that have never seen winter. Nan told recently crippled Bran a story of the long night in season one.
Oh, my sweet summer child, what do you know about fear? Fear is for the winter, when the snows fall 100 feet deep. Fear is for the long night, when the sun hides for years and children are born and live and die, all in darkness. That is the time for fear, my little lord, when the white walkers move through the woods. Thousands of years ago, there came a night that lasted a generation. Kings froze to death in their castles, same as the shepherds in their huts. And women smothered their babies rather than see them starve, and wept and felt the tears freeze on their cheeks. So is this the sort of story that you like?
Now, I'm pretty sure that the Long Night is a metaphor for this epic battle that's about to take place with the Night King, but what took winter so long to get here? Could something like that ever happen on Earth as we know it? First, let's break down seasons. The Earth spins around like a top on its axis, but the axis isn't pointed straight up and down, it's tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees. This tilt is what causes seasons. When the axis is pointed toward the sun, this causes summer in the northern hemisphere and winter in the southern hemisphere. The Earth then rotates around the sun to a point where the axis is pointed away from the sun. This causes winter in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. We've seen examples of both day and night assuring us that their planet is spinning. So what's causing these endless summers and these eternal winters? Scientists have speculated and they've come up with a few explanations to try and figure out what's causing these extended seasons in Westeros. Here are their top explanations. Number 3, volcanic activity. Okay, so we haven't actually seen volcanoes in Game of Thrones, but we know that there has been major volcanic activity in the past. Volcanoes were the cause of the end of the Valyrian civilization, so it's entirely possible that there was major volcanic activity that not only wiped out the Valyrians, but it ejected sulfuric acid high into the troposphere and into the stratosphere, thus creating cloud layers that are reflecting and blocking out the sun. This could easily cause mini winters or long springs and would definitely have an effect on the seasons in Westeros. Number 2, asteroids or comets. The Red Comet might as well have been a main character in season 2. So many people had so many ideas on what it meant. Some thought that it meant that Rob was going to be victorious. Some thought that the red symbolized the strength in the Lannister army. Dany thought that it meant that she should go into the Red Waste. But maybe it just meant that winter is coming and y'all need to get ready. Asteroid hits on Earth are completely irregular, but maybe the planet that they're on, they have asteroid hits more frequently. The last time there was a major asteroid hit on Earth, it killed all of the dinosaurs. Not because of the impact itself, but because the impact caused so much dust to be ejected into the atmosphere that it caused the temperatures to lower and the dinosaurs just could not handle it. It's entirely possible that the same thing is happening on the planet that they're on. The larger the impact, the longer the winter will last. And the number one explanation is most likely Milankovitch cycles. What's that, Philly? Okay, we talked about how the Earth is actually tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees. This is called the Earth's obliquity, and we know that it fluctuates between 22.1 degrees and 24.5 degrees. Secondly, we know that the Earth rotates around the Sun. This path is called its eccentricity. We know that the path is not completely circular, it's slightly elliptical. And third, if we imagine there's a rod that's inserted through the Earth from the North Pole to the South Pole, this rod is also slightly moving, and this is called the Earth's precession. If you put all three of those pieces together, they make up the Milankovitch cycle. This has been used to successfully predict the past ice ages and can also successfully calculate when the future ice ages will be. If we put all three of those pieces together for the planet of Westeros, I'm sure that they can calculate these extended winters as well. And finally, we have to keep in mind that the series is a fantasy, and sometimes these can be explained with just a little bit of show magic. But I also think it's pretty cool to try to explain the science behind the show. That's all I have for you this week. Make sure you tune in next Friday and every Friday to get your fix. Have a great weekend.